Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Hope you guys enjoy it. If you want more content like this, please don't be shy to subscribe, like, comment, and share. I really appreciate that.
The movie begins with a school bus going down an abandoned road. Then we notice one car parked on the road's edge. The car appears to be there because one of its tires has been punctured. That young lady in the car is on the phone with her fiancé. Meanwhile, the bus driver comes up to her and inquires what happened. The girl informs him that her car's tire has been punctured, and she has called for a tow truck, which will arrive at any moment. Regardless, the man keeps on inspecting her car tire. On the other hand, her fiancé tells her to stay alert and then hangs up after a while. Meanwhile, the driver returns to her and informs her that the car tire has been totally ruptured. Now, the girl thanks him for his assistance and tells him that the tow truck will arrive shortly. The van driver then gets into his car and waits a long time before starting it. That girl begins to suspect him as well. Before that girl starts her car, the man smashes the windshield with a hammer, then enters the vehicle and injures the female. Now that man is seen dragging the women along with him. After a few days, the police start to discover the woman's body parts. Her detective father is startled and disappointed that he was unable to save his daughter, despite being a detective. Her fiancé, Kim Soo-hyeon, who adored her, cannot express his sorrow to anyone and goes entirely mute, taking 2 weeks off work. He works with the National Intelligence Service as an agent. In the next scene, we find Kim Soo-hyeon meeting with another agent, who hands him a GPS tracker capsule and informs him that we can track their location and listen in on their talks if it is with someone. Now he meets his fiancé's detective father. He tells him of other persons who have been involved in similar situations in the past. Now, Kim Soo-hyeon sets out to find those people, and in the process, he brutally tortures two people. However, he is confident that the killer is not one of these two, and he is now on the lookout for the third. He arrives at her location and begins looking. Only then does he discover the girl's belongings in the drawers. During the search, he eventually finds the fiancé's ring. When Kim Soo sees the ring, he becomes emotional, but he also realizes that this residence belongs to the same murderer. Now the scene turns to the killer, who is driving somewhere in his school van with a group of girls. Kyung-chul has a thing for a girl in his truck, not because he likes her, but because he wants to kidnap her. Then we notice that the female has vanished from his van. When Kyung returns home with the girl, he is about to kill her when he's interrupted by a call from behind. After hearing his name, Kyung walks out and finds Kim Soo. Kyung inquires if he is alone, but Kim Soo remains deafeningly silent. Kyung believes he is a cop, but he is baffled how the Korean police were able to find him so quickly. He no longer waits for Kim Soo's response before attacking him and screaming angrily. However, he is unable to assault Kim Soo, and instead, Kim Soo severely defeats him. After a brief scuffle, Kim Soo covers Kyung's face with a large plastic bag, but he abandons him just as he is about to die. He then smacked his head on a large rock, but after a brief moment of thought, he let him go. He leaves him with the GPS capsule in his mouth. When Kyung comes to his senses, he notices a bundle on his chest and is surprised to see the money inside, leaving him to believe Kim Soo is insane. He then departs and takes a cab along the way. He asks the cab driver for a ride, but the other passengers in the cab are just like him. After killing someone, they were going to dispose the body. Then we see Kim Soo following Kyung around with the tracker he implanted in his body. Kyung has moved to a pharmacy since he was injured, where he casts a glimpse at a lady. Kyung begins to harass her since she is a caretaker. She begs Kyung to let her go, but Kyung is a psychopath who refuses to let her go. Simultaneously, Kim Soo arrives, knocking Kyung on the head and then thrashes him mercilessly. However, just as he is ready to die, Kim Soo saves his life by asking the caretaker to bandage Kyung. "It's not going to end now," Kim Soo says quietly to Kyung, "but it will grow worse, now you just wait." Kim Soo afterwards stabs Kyung in the foot with something. Later, we observe Kyung being dragged down from a car with a seriously damaged leg and wailing and shouting. Kyung is beginning to worry about how Kim Soo learned of his whereabouts. He inspects his clothing and shoes before inspecting his vehicle, but he doesn't get anything there. He rises from his seat and drives away. The action shifts to Kim Soo, who receives a call from his fiancé's father, who asks him to stop following the murderer because the cops will arrest him. Kim Soo, on the other hand, preferred to give him an agonizing death. Now we see Kyung in his home with his friends. Kyung tells his pals about all that happened to him. Kyung's pals also inform him that the person you killed may be a family member or an acquaintance of one of them. Kyung is now lying on the couch, pondering who he is, when he recalls a ring from which he deduces why he is being beaten up. Now, there's a girl who's been chained up at Kyung's residence. Kyung's friend begins dragging her to the kitchen, but Kim Soo arrives just in time to save her. Kyung's friend is taken aback and wonders, "How did you get here without making a sound? And how did you find this location?" He tries to attack Kim Soo, but he outclasses him and refuses to answer his questions. The police arrive at Kyung's house the following day and arrest them, but they are all injured, so they are taken to the hospital first. Now that Kim Soo is in the hospital, he is visited by the same friend who gave him Kim Soo's GPS tracker. Kim Soo's friend inquires about the tracker he gave him, to which he replies, "Yes, it works." He claims that it will continue to work till he is no longer constipated. Kyung overhears them while lying on the other bed, and when Kim Soo checks on him, he acts as if he is still unconscious. Kim Soo now places Kyung in a remote location and waits for him to do something that will allow him to teach him a lesson. But he does nothing because he has discovered that he has a tracker implanted in his body. Kyung is well aware that Kim Soo can hear him, so he informs him, "I've never played a game like this before in my life, and I'm sure you're listening. I know for which woman you are exacting revenge on me," he says, "and that girl has begged me for the life of herself and her kid that day." Now, Kyung visits a drugstore to obtain medications, which he eats, causing him to become constipated and the tracker to exit his body. Kyung removes the capsule and places it in someone else's body, which Kim Soo is entirely unaware of until he arrives. Kim Soo is at a loss for what to do, so he visits a friend of Kyung's who is in the hospital. "You might not be able to graze his thinking," he warns him. "He's going to start harassing your fiancé's family immediately. And even if you catch him after that, it won't make a difference to him." As Kim Soo walks away, he receives a call from a buddy who informs him that Kyung has lately declared that he will be doing highly important work and that it will not matter whether the police capture him. As soon as Kim Soo learns about Kyung's whereabouts, he becomes pretty concerned. Kyung intends to kill his fiancé's family, according to Kim Soo. When Kim Soo arrives at his fiancé's house, he is heartbroken to see that he has wholly wounded his fiancé's father and then left his sister to die. Kyung now wants to surrender because he knows Kim Soo will torture him to death. He phones the cops and informs them of his whereabouts. He arrives at the area where the cops are already waiting, but it's not what Kyung expected. Kim Soo takes him into a car before being caught by police and takes him to the same house where Kyung murdered his fiancé. Kim Soo ties him up in the exact location where Kyung used to murder his victims. Kim Soo has been torturing him far too much, and Kyung has had enough. "Why don't you kill me?" he asks. Kim Soo informs him that his death will not be made easy, and that he would experience the worst anguish of his life there, and he would suffer just like the people he had tortured. Kyung begs Kim Soo to leave him alone and not to murder him. He declares, "You must have heard all these words from people before, and today you're saying it yourself." Kim Soo continues, "And I have already suffered a lot. So tell me how you're feeling." "I don't feel the pain," Kyung says, "and you already know this, so I don't care if you kill me now." After that, Kim Soo stands up and ties a string to the door, thrusting the rope's other end into his mouth. On top of where Kyung is tied, there is a blade. If Kyung speaks while losing the rope, he will be killed, and the rope will also break if someone enters the door, killing Kyung. As Kim Soo leaves, a cab pulls up to Kyung's house. It belongs to Kyung's family. Kyung wants to stop them from opening the door, but he cannot do so because he will die if he speaks. Now, as soon as his family opens the door, that sword falls on him, beheading him. Kim Soo hears all of the Kyung's family's sad and terrifying voices here. Kim Soo sobs uncontrollably.
Hi everyone, if you enjoyed this video, leave a comment about what you found the most interesting and why.